She'll put in what the legal requirements are. Anything new, things like coastal road, like that, you wanna make sure you do what's legal, because everybody driving by there, somebody will turn you in if you don't, not doing it legally.
And what did he see there? I guess they could break water. It took some water.
They probably took samples, and that was probably oriented towards whatever little models in there. They weren't gonna be looking for anything that would pertain to what you're gonna do.
She had two ducks on the farm. She hasn't seen them since, so we don't have to bother.
Are you ready to start?
I'm ready. Sorry for the delay. I said sorry for the delay.
That's right. I'd like to call the special meeting of the town of Thurmond Board to order. Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Like to take roll call? Councilwoman Galusha?
Here.
Councilwoman Harris?
Here.
Councilwoman Needham?
Here.
Councilwoman Brown?
Here.
Supervisor Shepler?
Here.
Let the record show all present.
Thank you very much, everybody, for coming out this evening. The main reason is we have before us two resolutions that could not wait until the board meeting on the 11th of August. And also, we have a request from Kirk Grant from TSA in regards to the resolution that was passed at the last board meeting pertaining to their occupancy tax. She is requesting that we give it to her this week. In the resolution, it was that the town of Thurmond will grant those funds on or before August 1st to TSA. So I'm just making the board aware that I'm going to be cutting that check this week for her. Is there any issues with that from the board?
You already have a resolution.
I know, but I'm just saying, it was originally gonna be done on the first.
It said on or before.
On or before, but we had discussed the first at the meeting, so I'm just letting everybody know that we're gonna do it ahead of time.
But I don't know why we even need to discuss it, because you have the authority to do it.
That's fine, I'm informing you.
Okay.
As a board, that this is what I'm doing, okay? So, thank you. The next thing that I do wanna bring up is a resolution to complete the electrical work. Whereas the electrician was, the electrical work was started on the bandstand, and it was discovered that there was more damage than anticipated involving all the structures on the hill along with the salt shed. Be it resolved that the town board is authorizing the completion of the work not to exceed. Carl is here this evening, he is the electrician on record. He did send me a...
Wait a minute, you can't discuss this until you have it introduced.
We have a motion.
Can I please have somebody introduce this? Ed, thank you. Can I have a second, please? Doug, thank you. All right, as I was saying, the resolution was written before I received the job estimate, so that's why it says not to exceed with a client. I've asked Carl to come this evening. He is an electrician, I am not an electrician, so I am not the one who should be giving you the information and asking questions and answering questions. Carl, would you like to come before the board and give us a brief discussion as to what we have encountered up top, please?
Yeah, when we first looked at it, Sue didn't realize the trough on the outside had been totally rotted away. And the way this was done was, they're bonding...
Excuse me, but with your mask on, I can't...
Oh, sorry, no, I'm just used to wearing it everywhere I go, so... the way it was done, whoever did it, put it too low, but the way they did the bonds, they basically rotted away because the bottom is totally rotted out. I can show you pictures on the laptop, basically what I'm talking about if you want. But that's the first thing, and then when the panel was set up, it was set up incorrectly. It's a sub-panel off the main that's down by the building, by the maintenance. So the bonds in the grounds are totally wrong. But the thing that really was, there's four receptacles up underneath the bandstand that are to be utilized. But whoever wired it ran 12 wire over to the corner of the unit, put it on a 20 amp breaker. The breaker is actually seized shut, so it won't trip out. I tried to trip them out. But then they ran 14 wire from that junction box to the receptacles and ran 14, which in a commercial application is incorrect according to the NEC. So you're actually overfused on the wires, but they also added the paddle fan onto it, which is on 14 wire. So that circuit won't hold too much, but all the receptacles are just rotted out because they left indoor receptacles exposed to the weather. So we removed those, but we're going to install GFI receptacles for them, but the way they wired it, that's the easiest, fastest way to do it. And the intent is to replace the trough, raise it up, splice it over, run two pieces of 2-inch PVC from the trough outside to the panel, because the fill capacity on a 2-inch pipe is no more than 80%, and that was probably at 99%. I don't know how they got the wires in there, but somebody did. So between that, and then when we found that we got into the panel, again, they put the neutrals over on the bond, so that's got to be separated back over and isolated. There's a strip inside the panel that goes from the left bar to the right bar. That has to be removed because you have to have an isolated, insulated ground in a sub-panel, and that's considered a sub-panel because of the disconnect down by the meter. That's the means of disconnect. That's the service. So that is considered a sub-panel. But when we were taking things apart, I'm surprised that you guys didn't burn things out, because the lugs on the breakers, you can literally take your fingers and turn them. And that was like 80% of the breakers in there, and we really cranked onto them. So, and because that was doing that, it was creating arcs on the wire, and it was coating the wire. So again, it was a time bomb, but we just happened to
Yeah,
especially with the trough. I mean, it's sitting up there on the 6x6. I went to touch it and it just fell off onto my hand. So you'll see the six pipes just with the wires hanging out. So that's basically it. And then we're going to run, the intent is to run four individual 20 amp circuits. My question to you guys is, okay if we use EMT, electrical magnetic tube, pipe to bring it over and feed it? It's on the surface rather than trying to sink everything in the wall. It's conduit basically, it's EMT. If we run that, it's faster, it's easier, it's up to code.
And you're asking because of the appearance of it?
Some people don't like it, yeah, because these guys recessed the receptacles in the wall, mm-hmm. and they made it look like a house outside. Mm-hmm. But the fastest way to do the job, I figured we use pipe, put weatherproof boxes on it, make it watertight, damp proof because of the moisture in the air, and it would be a better job. It would be as neat as we can do it, but it won't be.
Has anybody talked to any of the electric to the musicians to see if the number of outlets is actual? I know we've been struggling in the past, I think.
A couple of them have used surge protectors, and I don't know if that's because we weren't GFI or what. They've also brought their own lighting in a few of them, so.
The average bandstand that I've done, 420 amp singles, you should do it.
Okay.
But again, if I run the pipe and I come under where I quoted you, which I should with no other problems, I was going to run six, just so you have.
Okay.
Again, I don't want to say what I can't, but I can probably do that because they ran 1 inch from the trough to the outside of the thing. So I'm going to change that little T11 box to a full 6x6x6 box, and I can pull my junction. So I got the means to do it. It's just there's a lot more labor than we initially looked at.
Are the GFIs required by code?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And with the GFI, we're not putting normal GFIs. They should hold up. I'm going to put weatherproof covers over them. Mm-hmm. They'll be in waterproof boxes, but the GFIs themselves are designed for damp, wet locations, not like your normal, like when they first came out.
I'm not electrician. electrician, and I don't pretend to be one, but I've had experience with one of these that makes me ask these questions.
The original receptacles are gonna be GFI, and they'll be waterproof. Not a big circuit, you plug a couple things in there and you probably will trip it out because it's 15 amp. I am downsizing it to 15 amp, so the wire gauge is the same. The new ones that I'm putting in, I am putting in GFI breakers in the panel. They hold up better than the receptacles themselves.
Okay, so the GFI breaker, that's the one that has its own pigtail?
That little white pigtail on it, yes.
The reason I'm asking, I had an experience where one was installed, wasn't required by code, and turned into a situation where it was just constantly tripping and it was a real pain in the butt. Found out it wasn't required by code, replaced it with a normal breaker.
What kind of application was it in?
Swimming pool, heat pump.
If the heat pump is a designated line, 110 or 240?
240.
There's a play on that in the code. Realistically, it should be, as of code as of right now. But years ago, you can get away with 240. They didn't have the GFIs, so you were allowed to do it. That code, New York State did not adapt that code. That still goes back to the 2012. So when they didn't adapt it, everybody got away with that.
Okay.
But if you read it today with the new ones coming out, it's in there because too many people are getting hurt.
Okay.
And that's why they now make two-pole GFI breakers.
I just asked because I wanted to avoid a situation where the concert keeps tripping breakers.
That's why I figured putting breakers in. The breakers seem to really hold up, but because you can reach that off with a 6-foot cord, the receptacles, and you're outside, it's not an enclosed building, that is mandated by NEC to have that. Yeah, they're a pain in the butt, just like the arc faults are in the house today.
I just want to add something, if you'll allow me. The fan that was, or I guess maybe still is there.
It's still there, no, I haven't taken it down.
Is an indoor Hunter Douglas fan. I went out and replaced it with an outdoor fan that will be installed, and it's supposed to, besides the fact that it's an indoor fan, it looks like a tulip, and I'm so afraid it's going to take somebody, put somebody's head or something. So we're trying to make this, I think, safe and it's possible for anybody who's going to be utilizing it. It was only, I think, $99 for the fan, so.
And that's basically it. And you should be in a lot better shape than you are.
Okay.
Yeah, and I agree with you on the trick. They're a pain. But I will have this work inspected. That is the other reason why the bus bars will be changed around in the panel. Because there's been a lot of hands in there, you can see that. So what I do, I want to cover myself so that if there is a problem, I'm at least covered by an underwriter. So
does this help all the structures up there?
This is just the one with the band sits on.
Pavilion.
Because it says violating all the structures.
Well, what you and I had discussed was there was a problem with the wiring. And you wanted to make sure everything was unplugged in the youth building?
Yes, that was
the pavilion, and then you've mentioned the salt shed.
Those two breakers are two poles. They're fed with number 4 and number 2 aluminum. Those are the ones where you can unscrew, and that's what I was saying. So they'll be re-put back on, cut back, clean aluminum with Penetrox right under the breaker, so you should be okay.
So it is affecting?
Yeah, it will affect those because they're fed out of that panel. And every nut, bolt, and screw in that panel will be re-tightened.
And the salt shed.
And the salt shed feeds from there too. Okay. Yeah, that will have clean connections on that. So.
Okay. Does the board have any questions for Carl?
I know nothing about it.
I know either, so that's why I invited you to see you. Thank you. So attached to the job estimate, and I believe Carl just stated that it may or may not reach the 3,900. It won't go over. So I think we're safe in saying on the resolution not to exceed 3,984, is that correct, Carl?
Yes.
Thank you.
We didn't identify where the money's coming from.
No, I didn't, because I'd like to have a portion of it come out of the occupancy tax fund. That stage is used This year it's going to be used for 5 weeks. In previous years it's been used for, I believe, 9 or 10 weeks. And I'd like to see it continue being used in that manner for the future. The remainder of the balance, I'm willing to take out the contingency fund.
When you say a portion?
Well, I think the board needs to discuss how much we can take out of the occupancy tax if we can't take it all out of there. And then I would take the remaining balance out of the contingency. I realistically believe that it should come out of the occupancy tax. As I stated, this is used and it does draw people from the outside. Do I have any further discussion?
How much is in the OT?
The what, the OT? Oh, it's 3,000. Or 30,000, yeah. Sorry.
30, I think 000. What she's asking is how much is in our bank account in OT, because we didn't budget anything in OT this year.
No, but I can transfer the money from the thank you, Randy, from the fund balance to the budget code. I do know in the other one here, I've got $4,300 that's planned. We're giving $7,000. We're going to have the porta potties that are going to come out of that. We're not going to get anywhere near the $30,000 for usage this year because this year ends on December 31st. So,
I'm going to abstain from voting on
this
with occupancy tax involved. However, I do want to say that prior to doing any of these resolutions, actually even prior to doing the resolution for the TCA, the money should have been put into the budget code because you can't actually, it's not legal for us to draw funds on a code that has no money in it.
I can transfer them tomorrow. I can transfer them.
I realize that we should. Money should be there when we pass the resolution because we're authorized.
Okay, we can look back.
So.
It will be. All right, so the money, I can transfer the funds. Does the board want me to transfer the full $30,000 into the budget code, or should I only transfer like $20,000 in there? We're not going to use the full $30,000 this year because it's the end of the year, basically.
It still should be there.
Oh, it'll be in the contingency.
It should be in the budget code.
You want the full 30 in the budget code?
That's up to the whole board.
Do you want to transfer the whole 30 over into this? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Well, not for, I mean, where I understood it, this is supposed to be, it should be in there.
It's
right? Is that not right or wrong?
We're playing backward accounting, yeah.
Yeah,
well,
I mean,
it should be. And I can guarantee you the money will be in there before I do write it, all right? So the question is, and I'm not sure I understand, you want the whole full $30,000 transferred into the account?
I think it should be. That's what it's called.
That's all the OT money is?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That may be nothing.
And that's left from last year that we're moving it into this year's budget code, but we don't get anything for this year until October or November.
And it should be better because it's taxes, sales taxes.
Well, it doesn't matter. You
know, I know, but
that will be in there. What about private school if they need this money?
They've applied for it and they're going to be given the $7,000.
Okay, so all we ask for is $7,000.
That's correct.
We're spending
$7,000.
Oh, no.
We just got to make sure
we're
paying
for it the right way.
I got it.
No, but you're going to transfer from this to that.
$30,000. Yes. Yeah.
And the $7,000 is already been transferred.
No, nothing has been transferred.
The board approved to give the TCA $7,000, but the money's not there.
Because
the money's in the fund balance.
Right.
And it needs to be brought from the fund balance
to the budget code, which it will be.
So the $30,000 is from the fund balance?
Yes.
There you go.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
So that still will be the names of Perky's group?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Whatever. Yeah, they just need to transfer enough money to cover that. And
So the board's pleasure is for me to transfer $30,000 from the contingent, from the fund balance into the general fund to the A6989.4.
You actually have to have a resolution to do that.
Well, we'll do one from the floor.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, what's the poll ratio?
6989.4. 69. Yes. 89.4.
It's going to be transferred from the fund balance to which one?
To the tourism code, the A6989.4. So we'll do a floor resolution.
Okay.
And it's going to be a resolution to transfer funds from the fund balance to the tourism budget code. And whereas the Town of Thurmond Town Board has directed the supervisor to transfer $30,000 from the town's fund balance into the occupancy tax tourism code A6989.4 to cover tourism related expenses for the 2021 year. It's not all just, this is not part of the resolution, but just so everybody understands, we're not even gonna.
So that's a motion, somebody needs to second it, the board needs to vote on it.
Right, so do I have a
Talk for a long person.
Ed?
Mm-hmm.
And you need a second?
I'll second it.
Doug will second it. Now we're gonna do a board vote.
Okay, Supervisor Shepherd?
Yes.
Councilman Needham?
Yes.
Councilwoman Harris?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilman Galusha?
Abstain.
Motion carries. So, we're going to go backwards now to the resolution to complete the electrical work.
It's already been introduced and discussed.
Yes, it has.
Mm-hmm. Well, you have to just vote on it.
And because we're going to take it out of the A6989.4.
Are you going to split it or take the whole thing?
Well, what does the board want? Well, I could take some of it out of the contingency fund, but then that just leaves that much less in contingency for the end of the year. Yeah, I know. And we're running heavy and hot with buildings and with garbage, so that's something to be considered.
Maintaining itself and close. I don't know. We had this discussion before.
Yeah. So is the board in favor of the $3,988.54 not to exceed coming from the 6989.4?
Yeah.
Ed?
It's left in the contingency fund.
It's $10,000, so that's got to go across the entire budget, not just.
Hold on, I've got it here.
It's $10,000.
That's what was budgeted. Is it all still there?
It hasn't been touched. I have not used any of it. I use it at the end of the year when we have to close out the accounts and balance everything. No, and I don't. I honestly, if you want to take some of it from there, that's fine, but just be aware that whatever we take out of there is not going to be available to us when we're closing the accounts out at the end of the year. Usually when we close the books out at the end of the year, the contingency fund is there to help offset the negative balance. $30,000, of which right now we're only taking $7,000, and possibly $3,900. And you've got porta potties.
At the moment, right.
Yeah, and you've got the porta potties.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much it. So you're not even going to get $20,000, but I do not believe in expenses until we leave a $10,000 in there, which was monies that was given to us for last year that wasn't utilized. And then in October, we're going to get another $30,000. So it could be as much as $40,000 or $50,000 left in that account for next year.
That's good.
So I would. It's utilized predominantly for the bands. So I don't know why we couldn't take it out again. So Doug, are you in favor of taking it out? Ed?
Yes.
I'm sorry?
Yes.
Okay, John?
Tell me what she was talking about over there. Where are you taking it from?
The tourism, the 6989.4.
Okay.
Because there's going to be approximately, I would say anywhere from, I don't think we're going to utilize $20,000 this year. I mean, we could, but the remaining balance is going to go forward for next year, plus in October of this year, we get the $30,000 for this year, so it would be $30,000 plus, let's say, either $10,000 or $20,000 left over, and that goes for next year, the 2022 year. So there's going to be plenty of money in the occupancy tax fund for next year.
Yeah.
So,
sorry.
The occupancy tax money is coming over to pay for the electrical.
Yes, because that is predominantly utilized for bands.
And it's 30, and how much is it you want?
For the bands, it's not.
I'm not talking about band, I'm talking about this person on the electrical.
Oh, for the electrical? It's not to exceed $3,988.54, but it could be a little less.
Okay. So, and you want to transfer?
I'm transferring, the board already voted to transfer the full $30,000 from the contingency fund into the A6989.4.
Okay.
So there's plenty of money there. I'm voting to have it come from the 6989.4. It'll read that the it resolved that the town board is authorizing the completion of work not to exceed $3,980.54 from A6989.4. Can we please have a roll call vote?
Okay, Supervisor Scheffler?
Yes.
Councilman Needham?
Yes.
Councilwoman Harris?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilman Galusha?
Abstain.
Thank you.
No reflection on you. I have to abstain because of the use of occupancy tax money. It's a long story.
So now we're going to go into the concert series. We have a resolution requesting funds for Monday night concerts.
Thanks. Thank you.
Okay.
Carl, thank you all. Okay. Talk to you tomorrow.
Okay, good. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So now we have a, I need somebody to introduce a resolution requesting funds for Monday night concerts, please. Thank you. Do I have a second? Ed, thank you. Okay. Resolution requesting funds for Monday night concerts. Whereas the town of Clarendon has scheduled Monday night concerts for the month of August of 2021, therefore be it resolved that the town of Clarendon is requesting a budget not to exceed $4,300 total for the five bands for 2021 to be taken from A6989.4. And that's where it's always taken from. Do I have any discussion?
Yes. Who was chosen for the bands?
Well, who chose them? pretty much I made phone calls from the ones in order that we had gotten them from last year, because they all said that they would come back.
Did the town board tell you to go ahead with it?
It was a discussion when you were not here, and the board asked me, have I done anything about this? And I said to him, I didn't want to start booking vans until I had an electrician look at this. Mm-hmm. We've got the electrician, then it was getting late, I started calling vans to see if anybody was going to be available or not. And so when they said they were available, I then asked if I could book them, and they agreed to that.
Did you discuss any kind of financing with them?
Yes, I did.
So how much are they paying?
It's the same rates that they were charging me last year. I've got two vans going for $1,200.
Which one? Two?
I have the Luster Kings and Stony Creek van. I have Big Fez and Reserve Mavics, Warren County Ramblers.
Oh, wait a minute, 6,000 here.
No.
What's the first two?
$1,200 each.
Okay, that's what I want to know.
And then the next one is
$1,200.
The first two were at $1,200.
That's right.
Then the next one is $700. Okay. The next one is $500. And the next one is $600. Comes to $4,200, but I'm giving myself a little bit of a pad in case I've erred in my math. I don't believe I have.
Have you contracted with Vince?
They are all taking it as a verbal agreement. Nobody is taking a written agreement at this point in time, and they were all fine with it.
Who gave you the permission to discuss money with them? And how can we tell that Faust and Phil?
Well, Joan, I can't bring a resolution to the board unless I know how much they're going to charge. All right?
Yes.
So
mention to the cop, to the van, and how much it's going to charge is a viable thing. But having to declare that you've already got them booked is not, because it hasn't been approved yet. That's all I'm saying. You're spending the money because you've already claimed that they're going to come for a certain amount of money, so that's expense, and you didn't get the permission from the board.
I am before the board now because I have the bands in
order.
No, it's not too late. I have the bands in order, and I have their amounts that they're charging. So I'm bringing it before the board, and that's part of the reason for this special meeting tonight, because it couldn't wait until the August meeting. I didn't have everything together for the July meeting, so that's why it wasn't brought before the board in July.
I think what part of what Joan's trying to say, and correct me if I'm putting wrong words in your mouth, is that you made a commitment to schedule these bands. Advertised and promoted the concerts, and you've done all of it without the board authorizing. I mean, technically, you're not supposed to contract for stuff without board authorization, and whether it's verbal or written, that's what you did.
Well, that's fine. That was my error, but
I mean,
these bands had to be booked.
I understand that. I'm not saying the board wouldn't have authorized it. Mm-hmm. It's just that you went ahead and did it without asking the board if the board was okay spending all this money.
Well, then how come the board sat here and asked?
I know she already did it ahead of this. This should have come first. We should have decided whether, the board should have discussed and decided, are we going to have concerts? If we're going to, how much money we're going to allot for it and spend for it? Mm-hmm. And we should have had a resolution to that effect.
Right.
And then she could have gone and started discussing with the bands and coming up with a schedule and promoting it. But instead, she went and did all of that without board authorization for any of the expenditure, which is not legal.
This is occupancy tax.
It
doesn't matter where the money's coming from.
And the board did ask me if I had started to book them. And as I said to you before, I told the board, not until I can get assurance of the electricity up there.
Look, I understand.
They're two different things.
No.
Just another chance for you to spend the money without authorization.
All right, listen.
All right? Just listen to me. You understand what I'm saying, right? It's not
in part I do, but Joan, I don't believe that there's ever been this sort of an issue with the Monday night concerts in the past. They were always previously booked in January.
And they previously were a committee already in place and approved.
No, there was never a committee in place.
Sure.
No,
PSA or something. No, myself, I booked them, but I couldn't book them until I found out.
When the TCA did it, it was done under contract with the TCA, which was done under a board resolution. So when they were booked in January, resolution contract was already done.
Right.
They were already been authorized. So, I mean, that's the thing is, nobody's arguing whether we should or shouldn't have the concerts or whether it should be paid for with occupancy tax money. Nobody's arguing about that. What's happening is that you're taking steps to contract with stuff which, according to town law, is not legal without the board authorization. And, I mean,
it's not the first time. I've been learning from the past. It's not the first time you've done this.
Thank you. Can we please get a roll call vote on this? Do you have any other discussion? No?
Where are we taking this money?
It's occupancy tax money. It always has been and always will be occupancy tax money.
Is that at 10,000?
Absolutely not. This is occupancy tax money.
Oh, exactly.
This is heads and beds money. Always has been. And it's been a greater amount than what we're using this year.
And it's been an organization.
Usually there's 10 or 12 bands, but things this year are way behind.
Last year, clearly the last time we did it was six, wasn't it?
Nine.
This year.
July, August.
Yeah.
Is that what we did last year?
Yeah.
Not last year.
Not last year, but the year before. We did nine.
Five in July, four in August.
Okay.
It's been a group or a person,
The panel that approved the occupancy tax distribution decided.
But because it's an ongoing thing, and truthfully, we only have to worry about it for the next 5 months, but it's an ongoing thing. It's not the first time, it won't be the last time, but it's getting to be tiresome that you just walk ahead and you don't want a dictatorship. You say you can't do anything else. You got a lot of work to get done, but you keep doing things you shouldn't be doing because you haven't been told to do them yet.
Thank you. We're back to the resolution. Can I please ask for a roll call vote on this?
Is Joan ready to what she wants to say?
I thank you for her comments, Randy. I'm tired
you
of listening to
you. You don't get to cut her off.
Yes, you can.
No. It doesn't work that way.
It's rude. Well, I'm not trying to be rude, but I'm also tired of listening to the same thing being redundant.
Well, don't keep doing the same thing. Don't keep doing and stepping out, spending money. Telling people they're going to get so much money when you haven't even been told that you can do it.
You're upset.
These rates are the same rates.
I don't care about the rates. I'm talking about that.
That's fine.
You're committing an illegal act and then you're getting upset because people are calling you out for it.
No, I'm not upset about it, but I will say if this is voted down tonight,
nobody's saying they're going to vote
it down. If it is voted down tonight, the board gets to call and cancel them because I'm not canceling them 2 years in a row.
Nobody's suggesting they should be canceled or called. This should be called off.
No.
We're expressing our frustration with the fact that you're committing town resources without board approval.
I understand that, but you also need to understand that when it's not even town money, it's occupancy tax money that is given to the town for heads and beds, and it is utilized on a yearly basis in the past for concerts as well as many other events. In order to get a commitment from a band and get Randy, I just need to know how much you're going to charge me this year because I have to go before the board. Now I can't go before the board until August, so I can't book you until I know that.
Because of COVID, I know this is up to here because you can't, normally they would be in maybe January to June. Try to get the bands because the bands aren't lining up. But they're not doing it at the last minute. So somebody has been chosen to do it, either a group of people or one person has been chosen to do that and has given them some information that we need or they need to do what you did. And the only thing is it's a sad thing that you just keep doing. A dictatorship is going out and doing everything, getting it done, and then coming to town and asking us if you can
do it. No. I haven't gone out and done everything.
You know how much you told me that you paid. You've got them advertised.
I just advertised.
No, you don't advertise, it doesn't matter if it's just, but it's the same problem that we had before.
I don't know what you had before.
But you do things without authorization.
All that needed to happen was at the point that you decided you wanted to do this, convene the board, get the board approval for an amount not to exceed, just like we did at the electrician.
Yeah, but I didn't have a clue, Randy, honestly.
But you knew from past, you knew from past experience what it cost. So you get, make sure that you cover yourself, you have enough money, you get board authorization to do it. It's all legal, nobody feels like they're being trampled on.
Okay.
And it's a board decision, and that's the way things are supposed to be done.
All right, thank you. But, I mean, the matter is at hand that we've got 5 concerts.
We have both, yes.
Yes, we do.
But we want your understanding that we don't want anything like this for the next 5 months. If I don't. You come to the board, you get what you want, and you ask for it, and it'll be nice, you get it.
Does anybody have any further discussion? Can we please have a roll call vote?
Supervisor Sheckler.
Yes.
Councilman Needham.
Yes.
Councilwoman Harris.
Yes.
Councilman Brown.
Yes.
Councilman Galusha.
Staying due to the use of occupancy tax money.
I don't blame you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. I appreciate it. The Monday night concert started Monday night, August the 2nd, with the Lustre Kings. I understand from an outside source that we have got quite a lineup. And that we should be very proud of. I do hope to see everybody there.
It's 7 p.m.
Yep, it's 7 to 9 p.m. It's a fun evening.
We're going to be in it for years.
Yep. So please come and enjoy yourself.
We have a motion to adjourn.
So there's nothing else in regards to any of this. So fine. Now or later. That's fine. It's always still good.
But this is your
stuff.
No, I know what I'm saying. If we got that kind of money and we have to use that in a year, we should adapt our budget so we don't have to use that contingency money at the end of the year. We can use it for contingency for stuff that we need during the year. Right?
Right.
So that's all I wanted to say.
So the next 4 weeks should be. You can bring that up.
I will.
You told her.
I'm sorry.
That it should be
possible. I'm sorry, but I will.
Or we can do it tonight. I don't know.
No,
that's what I'm told.
It's not on the agenda.
Somebody made a motion. Was that you?
No, I asked if we were making
a
motion. Because this, it looked like everybody was called about getting ready to leave.
Do I have a second?
I'll second.
And who made it, Doug?
Doug.
Yeah.
You can just write that in. Doug makes the motion from now until the end of the year.
Sometimes he gets cut off. Sometimes Doug's slow. Hey, I gotta go back and get the iPad.
Thank you, everybody, for coming out tonight.
I'll be down with the servers tomorrow.
Oh, all right.
Bye-bye. You too.